Good morning, it's about 10 past 9 a.m. GMT on Thursday, the 3rd of November 2022. Yeah, so Thursday, 3rd of November 2022, and this is a continuation of my broadcast regarding the next generation of F1 drivers or possibilities of that. We are on to Doohan now. Doohan could be a Alpine reserve driver next year, possibly. He finished fourth in the F2 standings this year, and so he won Silverstone. So what we're going to do is we're going to drive an F2 car at Silverstone. And there are still other ones to do in this series. There'll be Drugovich, Schwartzman, and De Vries. But De Vries I'll have to drive on an old edition of F1. Okay, so here's the home screen of the game, F1 2022. And then what you do, take your right bumper across. You're going to be doing solo, so Grand Prix, and then F2 2022, and we're doing Silverstone. There you see Guan Weizhou, who's now the first ever Chinese Grand Prix driver who drives for Alfa Romeo, partner of Valtteri Bottas. He's got the lap record here in F2. So it's doing, and what we'll do is we'll go through the list anyway. Primo, pretty strong team. So Hauger, the Norwegian, and De Ruvelo, the Indian, at Primo. Virtuoso, there's Jack Doohan, and Marina Sato, Japanese driver. We'll come back to Virtuoso, but we'll go through the driver lineup. Liam Lawson and Logan Sargeant, though we've done those in this sequence. Marcus Armstrong and Yuri Vips. Yuri Vips is Estonian, Marcus Armstrong is New Zealand. ART, Frederik Vesti, he's Danish, I think. And Pecheri came second in the standings, the Frenchman. Filipe Drugovic, the F2 champion, so we'll be doing him at some stage. His partner is Clement Novalak, the Frenchman. Ollie Caldwell, a Brit. And Ralph Boschong is Swiss, I think. Roy Nissany, Israeli. He used to be a reserve driver for Williams, not sure anymore. Or test driver. Iwasa is a Japanese. For sure, the Dutchman. And Callan Williams, the Aussie. Enzo Fittipaldi, he is the grandson of Emerson Fittipaldi, double world champion, the 1978 Brazilian champion, who claimed his titles in 1972 and 1974 in a Lotus car and a McLaren. His brother, Pietro Fittipaldi, could have a chance of the Haas seat, which is still rumoured that Schumacher will not be having that seat for next year. He's one of many contenders out there, so I'll keep you posted when I know a bit more myself about that. Chen Bullock-Barzi. So Chen Bullock-Barzi was actually an eSports driver, and then he actually has driven in the last season, most of it, in actual F2 cars, so I'm not sure what he's doing this year. And final one is Van Omerset, and it's Jake Hughes, who's a Brit, and Cordiel, who's a Belgian. So we go back, and we now know that we want Virtuosi. So Jack Doohan, select him and we go for our settings. So AI difficulty hard is 60 and manual race start, that is as it is in a car. Rules and facts, it's corner cutting stringency strict as it is in real life. You will be penalised for exceeding track limits. And this new setting unique to the F1 22 game is immersive pit stop experience, where basically you have to turn in at the right time to get better pit times. If not, we have broadcasts which will look after it as normal, automatically, as on other editions of F1. I'm not going to change the weather or time of day. It's Silverstone, so it could be wet. We can structure us. It's F2, so it's slightly different. So no practice, no qualifying for me, but I'm going to do a sprint and feature length race. And we're going to do, medium length for that. They will be short races, and we will not have to pit unless we damage is sustained on the car. Assist: I have a wireless control, not a PS, a wireless control on a PS4, not a steering wheel, and my track and my settings are braking assist medium, traction control medium, automatic gearbox, pit assist on, pit release assist on. I'm going to leave off EIS assist off for a change and DRS assist on. Start the event. No idea where I'm going to be on the grid. Doing is, as I said, finish fourth in the F2 standings, so maybe he'll be a little bit up the grid. After this race, what we'll do is we will actually replay it on the theatre mode.
Welcome to Silverstone, one of the staples of the Formula 2 Championship. It's a firm favourite amongst fans and drivers alike, and we're all keen to see what it has in store for us in today's race. The 3.6 miles of Silverstone circuit in Great Britain should be familiar to fans and drivers alike. Built on the site of a World War II airbase, the track features 18 corners and some good opportunities to overtake at the end of two DRS zones, located on the Wellington and Hanger Straits. Joining me today in the commentary box is 2012 GP2 champion Davide Valsecchi. We all know the circuit so well, Davide. What's got your attention today?
Always a pleasure, Alex. Everyone looks forward to Silverstone, and which is such an intriguing grid, I think the fans will be excited for the start of today's race. We know these young drivers are hungry to prove themselves. Hopefully, we'll be seeing some more history being made today.
So it's a decent start. Too bad considering we got knocked there. Still top 10. The S's of Silverstone. pits on the right hand side. Just lift it a bit there. Fellow Antipodean Armstrong, the New Zealander. Definitely driving a bit better now. Amazingly well to keep that together. you're going for the S's again, are you? So, no time penalties so far, anyway. So if you are wanted to bypass the celebrations, press the X button.
Dams, another team with a huge...
Then press again.
Who would you say was your driver of the day?
Let's give it to Felipe Drugovic. That was a quality drive from start to finish. He can be proud of that one.
After all this drama, you'd be mad not to join us for the next race. We hope to see you then. Take care.
So, doing slower than a lot of others. Over 2 seconds slower than most people. Got hit a few times. And one amazing save. Well, I think I was going to crash. I don't know how I didn't. So, carry on.
Let's take a look at the grid positions for today's race. Frederik Vesti lines up on pole position, and it's Liam Lawson alongside. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Porcher, Nissani, Marino Sato, Sargent, Doohan, Deruvola, Awasa, Ollie Caldwell, Fittipaldi,
Hauger,
Jake Hughes, Novalak, Bulkpassi, Boschon, Drugovic, Callan Williams, Armstrong, Phipps, Cordiel, and Richard Vershaw completes the grid. And with preparations almost complete,
Okay, so 7th. Looking for a top 10. So the trick is to not hit them like that. That was Sergeant. Now, next thing I'm going to look for is try and get myself a gap between me and Darubala and Caldwell at the back. It's a good effort to overtake him there. I'll get him there. Next bit is the S's. Okay, just about legal. Just use no rumble strips. So, got 0.7 behind me. Darubala and Caldwell, good start. If I can hang in here. Just overdid it a bit, overcooked it. Penalise that. Chase down this 16th. 5 laps to do it in. This is where I've lost a bit of traction. Drugovic behind me. Remember he won the title this year. Just about legal. On legal there. Now Boschen has got away 4.5 seconds.
There's a new strategy available on the MFD.
No point changing, there's only 4 laps left. crazy Whitehall battle. So welcome to these broadcasts about the next generation of possible F1 drivers. You join me as Jack Doohan, who came fourth in the F2 standings this season. This is my second race. And I finished 17th last time, and it looks like I'm going to do worse this time. Is rumoured to possibly get an Alpine reserve drive, but I'll let you know when I know more myself. So last lap, see if we can chase them down. Thanks to the famous S's of Silverstone. Tight to the track limits, but legal, just about. It stops to the right hand side. Now we've got some step corner that problems with.
they climb out of the car, the ART team are ready and waiting to celebrate a thoroughly deserved win. So, Davide, how exactly did they set themselves apart from the pack today?
The difference was in the structure. Maybe to the driver, for sure. But races like this really drive home how much of a team sport this is. They did a lot of work on the pit wall to really make the most of its speed and to make the best use of the signs. That said, all of that would have been for nothing without a talented hand on the wheel.
ART, the French team who have been racing since the 90s in various forms of motorsport, are once again back on the winner's podium today after a brilliant display of driving skill.
Okay, so if you want to bypass the podium celebrations, etc., just push the X button once.
And so, driver of the day then, Davide Valsecchi, who do you think you'd go for?
Difficult call, but I'd like to say Theo Pourchaire. He's just so gifted at getting the most out of the tires, and he showed that today.
Well, what a weekend that has been. Please join us next time for another thrilling installment when Formula 2 returns.
So, Jack Doohan, 2 second time penalty, that's made a big difference. Slowest lap, 1:47.25. Okay, so next we're actually going to do Philippe, going to drive as Felipe Drugovic, the Brazilian driver. Going to find out where he won, and I want to do a track that we haven't done on this series so far, so just give us 2 or 3 minutes. So Drugovic did a double at Barcelona in Spain, so we shall do that. And Drugovic is going to be an Aston Martin reserve driver, and he'll get his practice debut at Abu Dhabi. So we're so it's F2 23-2. Spain. He drives for MP Motorsports. There he is, yep. I'm just going to check my EOS assists settings. Go out of his now. I want to use, I'm going to have to change my EOS settings. Just remember where to go to that. Maybe under game options. Control, maybe. So what's it under? Controls. We'll put the assist back on, I think. We go back to solar. Do 2022. So we're doing Spain. Oh, not just see that one. There's Drugovic, the Brazilian. So walls and flats, corner cut and stringency is strict as it is in real life. Immersive pit stop experience and unique to the F1 22 game means that you have to turn in at the right time to get faster pit stops. Otherwise, if you press broadcast, it will be looked after for you. So we stick that on. We haven't time of day. We won't twinkle with that. Weak structure. There's no practice. There's no qualifying. It's a sprint and feature race format. And we're doing medium. There's the assists. Wireless control on PS4, not a steering wheel, so it's medium braking assist, medium trust control, automatic gearbox, pit assist on, pit release assist on, EI assist on, and DRS assist on. Start the event. Should be quite high up on the grid, I would think, because the F1 22 game does try to reflect recent form in real life. So with Drugovic being the champion, so yeah, Drugovic got both wins in Spain.
Hello and welcome to the Circuit of Barcelona Catalunya. We're counting down to the start of today's race and you can feel the excitement in the air. This promises to be a real spectacle. In commentary, I'm Alex Jakes.
Right hand side and at the back. First thing to do is stay in contention and don't hit anyone. See the track limits to do that. The main thing is not too far away from them all. will take that. I can stay in contention. This is a risky move now. So yeah, the trick is to get close to them, don't hit them. Wait to the next straight. That's good driving, this is. Where one is he? Head. Just within DR's territory. Very, very tight on the rumble strips, but just about coping with it. Definitely closer to him. Closer than that. That's not, still 1.3 behind. Bips is only 0.3 behind, so I need, we need to get going here. Get down the side of him here.
Come on, you can win that place back.
Damn. The run's getting worse. Pips passes lap, sees him go flying past me. He must be doing 2 seconds quicker. So, talking to my engineer there. Very useful feature on the MFD button there.
Stuff from Dams today. What a superb victory. Davide, what do you think made the difference here?
It was down to one thing. Consistent pace over everyone else out there on the track. We could spend a great deal of time talking about ways and tyres structure, what else occurred on the track, but at the end of the day, the difference here was down to simply being faster on the track than everyone else. Amazing skill on show.
Can see our drivers making their way out now. It's been a sublime team performance, and it's the culmination of a lot of hard work. Dams are your winners today.
Okay, so if you don't watch the podium celebrations, just press the X button.
And now, Davide Valsecchi, let me ask you, who is your driver of the day?
Let's give it to Roy Nissany. That was a quality drive from start to finish. He can be proud of that one.
After all this drama, you'll be mad not to join us for the next race. We hope to see you then. Take care.
So not that slow lap times compared with the rest, really. Okay. So we move on to the feature race. Let's hope we're further up the grid than we were at the back last time.
we're back for today's second sprint race. We reverse the top 10 on the grid, and the drivers are almost set. This is looking to be a thrilling conclusion to the end of day one. Here is the grid for today's race, which will be starting shortly. Theo Pourchaire will start on pole. Fantastic qualifying from him, with Frederik Vesti alongside. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Sargeant, Lawson, Ayumu Owasa, Doohan, Hauger, Deruvola, Nissani, Marino Sato, Williams, Vachon, Ralph Boschong, Bullock Bassi, Novalak, Fittipaldi, Cordier, Jake Hughes, Caldwell, Dragovic, Armstrong, and Yuri Vips starts from the back of the grid. Now it's almost time to lights out.
Okay, so back of the grid again. I think I prefer left hand side. I think I might be on the right. I'm on the right. Right, I'm really going to go for it this time. Just going to try and get up some positions on the first lap. Good thing is Vips is 2.7, since I remember he charged past me in the last race. Although it is a longer race, there'll still be no one pitted unless they have damage. So there's no point really going in. A bit more positive this. Vips is 2.5 seconds behind. So I'm not that far behind the ones in front of me. This is where I need to be a bit bold up. Here. This tricky bit here. That's close to track limits, but it's not track limits. Can I get within a second? Just over a second. Vips is at the fastest lap. This is exactly what he did last time. So it'll be rare of him. Not dismissing Caldwell's challenge, but Vips is a better driver. is now within DRS territory. No, just away again. Okay, get back into contention with these. Vips as my benchmark. At the moment, the gap is getting bigger. This is good. And I'm closer to these now. Come on now. And Armstrong is within DRS. This is a good sign. Halfway through the race. It's not easy to overtake on Spain though. But we'll just keep this gap. Sector for me there, you can see that's good, good sign. Now we're getting towards. Much closer now. I thought it wasn't that low. Vips is closing. He's only just behind me, you can see him. There's a chance here, maybe. Into this again. We just get one more position. Good battling. Vips is over a second behind again, and I'm within Armstrong. Got a 2 second buffer to Vips about that now. So if you can get ahead of Armstrong. better drive than before. Vips is over a second behind. Maybe he was at 0.3 at one stage. More crucially, I'm in DRS territory again. Again, got to find a place that's safe to overtake against Armstrong. This could be it here. Just wait around here. It's not quite the line, will it? But I haven't got done. Just outside DRS territory, Armstrong, and Vips is closing again. Strong again. Okay, so now Vips is on my tail again. So it's Caldwell. Well, how can you get away with that? Crash straight in the back of me. So started 20th, and keep it clean now to the end, finished 20th. Oh no.
Okay, we've lost
Vips is battling with me again. Harder than last time. Oh. Just turned in there the right time. Keep it clean. Finish off the race. Okay, so 20th.
Okay, pick up rubber and bring it home. It was a magnificent race and a drive right out.
So if you don't want to see the podium celebration, press the X.
An amazing race today and a
very good.
Who would you say was your driver of the day?
My driver of the day was Theo Pourchaire. He did a cracking job moving through the field. Just a very good race.
That's the end of today's race. Thank you for joining us. And I'm sure you'll agree it was a great race and sets us up nicely for the next installment.
So, 134 points.
Take care. From Davide and I, it's goodbye.
115. Better than Beauchamp. Bolt-Barzi, Novalak, Cordiel, Hughes, Armstrong. Yeah, so that's pretty good. Slower than Vips though, but great driving, keeping it tight, no exceeding the track limits. And fighting off Vips at the end. Started 20th and finished 20th. And to be honest, probably maybe should have been a bit more risky trying to take over Marcus Armstrong, who I got within DRS territory a few times. Okay. Okay, so what I'm going to do is going to show you the races. There's the theatre. There's Drugovic at Spain. And sprint race and. So let's have a look at Doohan first. So he's seventh there. Let's see how he gets on. So I think I'm in the blue there. And that's him now, blue coming towards the screen. You see him there? dropped right down. He got whacked.
He dropped right down. He got whacked.
15th. Went off there. That's another.
Went off there. That's another.
I didn't get to go down to go down another place. 16th. Overtake there. We're doing to 16th. Down to 19th now. We've got to. Chen Brook Basie there. Just keeping him away. Okay. So what I'm going to do is. So let's have a look at Djokovic.
So let's have a look at Djokovic.
That was 22nd and the 20th. So let's look at the print sprint race first. So 20th. And I'll be in a orange one for MP Motorsports. You'll see me right at the back, 20th. There I am on the right hand side. And then I'm at the back. Nope. And yeah. We've never really caught up with the drivers in front of me. Playing catch up all game, all day. Tried an overtake there, and it worked. Then it didn't work. dear, look at that. All over the place. Vips. Had a right old battle in this space. And then I come in last. Very quick commentaries there. So this is the feature race at Spain. This was 9 laps as against 7 for the sprint race. 25% race distance. So, 20th. Right-hand side again. Got to 19th there. There I am in the... It's a good shot of Djokovic going away there from the other three at the back. Is quite a good recovery from there. Back in the battle with Vips there. Don't know how either one of us didn't get penalised for colliding with each other, but we did. Lap 6, here we go, so 20th. That's where I started, 20th. I was got hit again. And now, watch this one here. This is where they overtake me, I think. Yep, gone down to 21st. But I battle away with him there. Finally, see them both off. Again, they're after me, look. That's they're very close to me. But I held them off. Again, they're still battling at the end. Still battling right to the very end. Even there, look. Just about got ahead of him there. Going into the final corners. And saw him off. Statistics wise, it doesn't look like a great race being 20th. I did start 20th on the grid though. And I was battling with Vips. And Caldwell, I think it was. Okay, so thank you for watching. Catch me again. Follow me on Twitter at SportyPH2 for motorsport updates. Football updates. Okay, so thanks for watching. Catch you again. Bye-bye. One or two drivers left in this series of broadcasts. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.